The U.S. Navy's aircraft carriers are colossal marvels, often likened to bustling cities afloat. Here, amidst the organized chaos, aviation engineering takes center stage. Like clockwork, a jet launches or lands on this dynamic runway every 20 seconds, a feat that demands exceptional skill. Picture the high-stakes scenario if a jet falters during an arrested tailhook landing on one of the world's most demanding runways. The repercussions of a failed landing of this kind are monumental. A jet unable to halt on the plate could plunge into the ocean or, worse, wreak havoc on the deck, endangering the crew and other aircraft. Such an incident imperils not just the pilot, but also the invaluable equipment and deck crew. In the confined confines of an aircraft carrier, with jets hurtling at high speeds, the margin for error is razor thin. Tragically, history has witnessed the dire outcomes of such failures. But what exactly is an arrested tailhook landing and how does it function? While it might sound like a scene from a Hollywood blockbuster, it's a vital, highly technical maneuver in military aviation. This technique is executed daily on the compact carrier deck. During an arrested tailhook landing, a specific aircraft component takes center stage, the tailhook. Positioned at the jet's rear, this robust hook is pivotal. Upon landing, it descends, aiming to catch one of several tightly stretched arresting cables across the deck. This cable, linked to a hydraulic brake system, snaps taut as soon as the hook secures it. This rapid action brings the high-speed jet to a halt in a remarkably short distance, a symphony of precision and engineering marvel. Yet even with this technological wonder, mishaps can occur. What if the tailhook misses its mark or the cable snaps? These are not mere hypotheticals, but real-time challenges faced by carrier crews. A myriad of factors, from technical glitches to adverse weather, can disrupt this finely tuned dance of technology and precision. Pilots mastering these landings undergo years of rigorous training, acclimating to the unique carrier challenges, the confined space, ship motion, and rapidly shifting weather. They rehearse tirelessly to perfect their timing and reflexes. Nonetheless, there are moments when landings go awry, ushering in a flurry of swift, decisive actions. It's in these moments that life on an aircraft carrier reveals its true nature. In the event of a failed arrested tailhook landing, a term comes into play, a bolter. This occurs when an aircraft misses or fails to grip the arresting cable. The pilot must promptly go full throttle, skillfully guiding the jet skyward for another attempt. It's an adrenaline-charged moment, a testament to the pilot's skill and the aircraft's reliability. However, precision is paramount, as a minor misstep could lead to catastrophic consequences. Meanwhile, on the flight deck, the crew faces their own trials. If the arresting cable snaps, a rapid and efficient replacement is imperative. This is no small feat. The cable is hefty and unwieldy, demanding both strength and finesse. Despite the immense pressure and potential hazards, the crew executes this task with military precision and speed. They're also primed to respond swiftly to bolter-related contingencies, from clearing deck debris to preparing for an emergency landing. If a jet overshoots the deck edge, an immediate rescue operation becomes essential. Jets are equipped with ejection systems, enabling pilots to safely exit in emergencies. Once in the water, a rescue helicopter is promptly dispatched. Additionally, safety measures are enacted to mitigate risks. Deck crew don heat-resistant suits, helmets, and specialized goggles to shield against jet engine exhaust. They're equipped to handle potential scenarios such as fuel releases or hazardous substance incidents. Given these risks and the intricate nature of operations, carrier crews and pilots persistently refine their skills. The Navy conducts regular flight deck drills involving the entire crew, simulating a range of scenarios. These drills are a pivotal aspect of daily carrier life, preparing the crew for every possible situation, from routine flights to emergencies. One crucial facet of these drills involves simulating emergencies, encompassing failed landings, fires on board, evacuations, and potential threats. Crew members operate under pressure, swiftly adhering to safety protocols. In the case of a simulated failed arrested tailhook landing, crew members rush to secure the deck. Medical staff stand ready to provide aid if needed. Effective communication is paramount during flight deck drills. From pilots in the air to ship leadership, precision communication is a must to manage the situation. In the clamor of the flight deck, where verbal communication is challenging, hand signals are indispensable. They facilitate swift and efficient communication in an environment where spoken words vanish amidst jet engine noise. These gestures aren't random, they're part of a standardized system used Navy-wide. For instance, to signal an aircraft to go full throttle for takeoff, a crew member, often called the shooter, makes a distinctive hand motion resembling pulling an imaginary lasso over their head. Once the aircraft reaches full power, the shooter extends their arm forward, palm down, signaling the pilot to take off. On the deck, crew members use hand signals to guide taxiing aircraft, a delicate operation in the compact, bustling space. To halt the aircraft, crew members cross their arms above their heads. In the event of a bolter, other hand signals come into play. If the tail hook misses the arresting cable, the crew simulates striking an imaginary table, a signal for the pilot to go full throttle and attempt another takeoff. Pilots themselves employ hand signals to communicate with the crew. If a pilot encounters technical issues, they place their hand on their helmet. Additionally, hand gestures convey deck conditions. A thumbs up signals a safe and ready deck, while crossed arms indicate danger, such as debris or a broken arresting cable. This extensive system of hand signals enables swift responses to an array of situations. It's a vital element of the intricate ballet that unfolds on the aircraft carrier deck, a dance of precision and speed driven by the imperatives of safety and efficiency. Even during aircraft refueling, hand gestures play a pivotal role. When refueling is complete, a crew member signals with crossed arms and an X above their head. Moreover, there are gestures to initiate engine startup. A crew member rotates their finger in a circular motion, signifying readiness. In night operations, when visibility is limited, illuminated batons enhance the visibility of hand signals, each color conveying different instructions. While this system of hand signals is indispensable, it's worth noting that it's supplemented with other forms of communication. Radio communication remains crucial between the tower and airborne aircraft, as well as among crew members in different ship areas. In conclusion, living aboard a Navy ship presents a myriad of challenges. The confined space, constant motion, and demanding operations require unwavering discipline and skill from every crew member. These unsung heroes, through meticulous training and dedication, ensure our skies remain safe day in and day out. Their work aboard these floating cities at sea showcases human ingenuity and teamwork, underscoring that every move and second matters.